Okay, guys, come in. Oh, who are we missing? Okay, alright. Can you grab a piece of A3 paper and a coloured pen when you come in?
My life.
Just one coloured pen.
Decision making.
And then just put your bags down and spread yourself out around the lab.
Paper, yeah.
No, maybe like drawing.
Maybe drawing first. Yeah, so put your bags down, spread yourselves out. Okay, so we're going to do, you need to stand up. You have to stand up. So we're going to do a quick exercise to start us off, to try and review what we started last week. I'll just get one for Rhea. She arrives. So I'd like, we're going to have a silent discussion. Okay, so basically I'm going to ask you a question, and I'm going to ask you just to, on that piece of A3 paper, to write down whatever kind of things come to your mind. It doesn't matter what they are, okay? And then you're going to rotate to someone else's paper, okay? And you'll have another minute to add more thoughts to what they've written, or even comment on what they've written, or ask questions or something like that. Okay, does that make sense? Okay, all right. So, the question is, what are proteins? All right, so I'm asking you to think about what we learned last week, all right? And I'm going to give you now a minute to just write down everything comes to your head when you think, when I ask you, what are proteins? Okay, time starts now.
Do you write our names?
No, no, don't need to write your names. Just write, just use this as a chance to kind of get your head back into the biochemistry. Don't feel you need to like write in neat sentences. You can just write on the page. Use it as a canvas, an artist's canvas. Single words are fine. Just think of like keywords, anything that kind of comes to mind from last week. Rare is here, right?
Yep.
Sorry.
Oh, hello. Okay, everything okay?
Yeah.
Alright, Rare, if you can stand here. So, put your bag down. I'd just like you to write down all the things you can think of. But if I ask you the question, what are proteins? I just want you to just to sort of regurgitate your ideas onto that piece of paper.
Okay.
Alright? I'm not assessing you, don't worry.
Yeah.
Give yourself a chance to think about last Wednesday's lesson, that whole period. Stop there. Right. So you're now going to rotate. We'll go clockwise. So Ray's going to go to Lewis to Leo's and round. Okay. And read what person's written. Okay. And add any questions or comments or further kind of thoughts to their responses.
Keep your color.
Keep your color. Yeah. Keep your color. Good. All right. incorrect, then correct it. Most living organisms need them as nutrients. You can write the same thing you wrote before as well, okay? If your thinking hasn't changed. Okay, Brad?
Yeah.
Not had your coffee this morning. Rotate once more, please. Don't need to just write, you can draw as well. Do anything. Don't mind. Organisms. Okay, 10 seconds and we'll rotate again. Writing and then rotate, please. Thank you. Okay, another 10 seconds and we'll rotate. Rotate, please. Thank you.
There's a pressure.
The final minute. Okay, final 15 seconds. Hands down, don't move just yet. Right, what I'm going to ask you to do is go back to your starting position. I'm going to give you one more minute now to, with your own colour and your own your own pen, to some, if there's any themes or key ideas or that kind of appear to you in what's been written on your work, I'd like you then just to take a minute now to create a sentence or two sentences, short phrases, whatever, to summarise what's been written onto your A3 paper. Okay, so just literally 1 minute. All right, so just have a read of it and write your thoughts in response to that down. Okay, your time starts now. Okay, right, stop there. Right, last thing I want you to do is stay where you are. Well, I'm going to give you 30 seconds to get the material you'll need. What you need to do is get your workbook, right, 2.4 workbook. Okay, again, this is silently. Get your 2.4 workbook, take it back to where you're located, all right? I want you to now spend 1 minute, all right, flicking through it, reviewing what we did on Wednesday, okay? And then I'll give you another minute if there's anything you want to add to this document, okay? So again, what are proteins? And I'm thinking about key points, key terms, okay? So we'll give you 30 seconds to get your stuff, all right? You need, you can do that now, Leo, Raphael, to grab your workbook.
Oh,
haven't woken up this morning.
Yeah.
No. Unfortunately, most of our lessons are first period, right? So.
Coffee
changes everything. It does. It certainly does for me. Anyway, how's
your?
That's not good. That's really not 16, 17. That's not the best thing. You know, when you get to my age, and it's like you have to have four before you can even start feeling normal. Alright, so, get your stuff. Excuse me. I'm going to give you a minute now just to review what we did last Wednesday. So have a look through the exercises, any of your responses to the connect. Don't write anything down yet, okay? So just have a read, so a minute's reading time. You can sit down now, Liz, that's all right, if you want to. If you like, prefer to stand, you can stand. I don't mind.
I don't realize the room's sitting down.
Just try and remember what we did last Wednesday. Have a look at the understandings from the syllabus that we covered, the exercises we did. Okay, right, one last minute then. I'd like you to now just, anything else you want to add to this bit of paper that you think, okay, proteins, what's missing from what's been added? Let's add something else to it. So one more minute now, just to add your thoughts. Doesn't need to be pretty. Okay, 10 seconds. And stop there. Okay. What do you think of that exercise? Raphael,
nice.
What's nice about it?
Because we can see others, like what people know about it and things with what we know and then get all together.
So can I ask you a personal question? Bear in mind we're being live streamed. How did that affect you? How do you think, can you reflect on us for the class, like how that perhaps changed your thinking about this topic from 20 minutes ago?
I know things that I didn't know before. Like that
good choice of words
like
there.
A revision, kind of.
Good. Okay. So you feel like it, over the last 20 minutes, you've just what? How would you say? Describe how you remembered more. Okay. Anything else?
Maybe answer other people's questions. Maybe think a little bit more.
Okay.
Like based on what the other one wrote.
Okay.
Like answer Rhea's question with what she wrote, and maybe like remember.
Okay. Cool. All right. Anyone else? Any other comments about this exercise? Yeah.
Was this when it comes to like a test or something?
Yeah.
I'll relate back to what we did here, so I'll remember it.
Why?
Because it's a thought process, basically, and you can kind of remember all the things that you thought, and then what kind of things that you learned, maybe, or that you forgot, and like, I'm pretty sure I'll be able to remember most of those elements.
How does it feel to write your thoughts down and then have someone else comment on it and then read their comments? How does that feel? We're all friends here, right? Yeah, why?
To review your own thought process at the same time as the major question itself, which you actually do.
Yeah, okay, good. So getting some kind of quick, really, really quick kind of feedback, okay? So that's an exercise actually called Chalk Talk. Basically the idea is just to have a kind of silent discussion, okay? And it's I guess what I'm trying to hopefully get you guys to a point in our class is that you can feel, you know, maybe silently at first, but get to the point where you're happy to give each other some sort of feedback. It's one of the best ways to learn, actually, to review what we know, and to sort of remember things kind of going forward. Obviously, the reason I've wanted to do this morning is I just want to highlight something to you. Last term, I set you a lot of formative work in terms of finish this exercise, review these exercises, do this, da 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 da. Okay? I want those. It was kind of like last time you can think of it as being like when you're learning to ride a bicycle, okay? When you're a kid, a little kid, and you have like those stabilizers on the back wheels, right? So stop you falling over. Yeah? Okay? So what I'm trying to do is to get you to reflect on your own learning and the way that you as an individual actually learn. Okay? One of the key things to success in this subject, okay, is review, 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 okay? This type of exercise, we're just taking 20 minutes, okay, to get you to kind of come back to stuff we looked at last week, right? How much did you actually remember? It's going to vary. I'm not necessarily going to ask you. I want you to think about that for yourselves. It's going to be different for each of you. Okay. The point is, this kind of exercise is just the sort of thing that you should find some space. It's 20 minutes. Wouldn't necessarily need to be that long. You couldn't necessarily do this on your own. But what you could do is you could go home. You could take 15 minutes at the start of, you know, I don't know, 8 o'clock, whenever you start your homework, whatever, you could just take 15 minutes and go, right, well, what did I do in biology today? Or, better yet, last night, we have a lesson on Tuesday, okay, Monday nights, you could kind of spend 15 minutes, right, what did we do last week in bio? What can I remember? Get a big piece of paper, and I'm just going to write down what I can remember, and then I'm going to do that for like 3 minutes, and then I'm going to just review my notes for another 3 minutes, then I'm going to add some more thoughts to that. Done. That's what I mean when I say to you, review. You should come to class. It's going to make our lives much easier if you can come in on Tuesdays, like brains in. Like I remember what we did last Wednesday. It's quite a long break. Do you know what I mean? Okay. So just to why is this also important? If we were to. So what point am I making? I'm saying brainstorming is quite a good way just to spend 10-15 minutes reviewing what your learning was from last week. You can do it in any subject. But it's really important. We'll make much more progress if you guys come in on Tuesdays like, yeah, I remember that stuff from last week, okay? If we plotted, time against memory, right? You are taught something, let's say you're taught something on time zero, yeah? If we were to plot your recall of, let's say, proteins, like, the proteins are, let's say, a fact, like, I don't know, there's 20 amino acids that can make proteins, okay? Over time, that's gonna happen, okay? How your, if we were to plot, like, on over time, like how much you're gonna retain, if this is 100%, over time, within a week, so this is 1 week, okay? You're gonna probably remember about 10% of what you of what we covered in class. Okay, that's just the way your brain works. All right. The reason is your brain is a plastic organ. Right. What it does is it makes it the cells in your brain make connections with each other. Okay. Connections that get used a lot. Okay. So for example, that's that fact 20 amino acids. If you hadn't even thought about that fact again from last Wednesday, you're not going to remember it because the memory of it is stored within connections within your brain. And if those connections are not used, then they disappear. Your brain is constantly kind of making connections and taking connections away. Yeah? To remember something, you have to revisit it in your head or in conversation or in some way. You need to think about it. You need to use it. You need to talk about it. Otherwise, this is going to happen. You're going to remember less and less and less and less. Okay? And that's just a fact of your biology. It's just what it, that's just you. That's just me. That's all of us as human beings. In terms of learning, though, right? If you just take 10 minutes, okay, then every time you recall something, all right, you're actually, so if this this acts as like, let's say, first recall, first time you actually go, oh, I remember that lesson, I remember doing that. What you actually do is you improve your memory of that topic, okay? And what happens if, the more that you do that, the more you will actually retain that information. The only reason I'm a DP biology expert, yeah, is because I teach the same stuff every single year, yeah? There's no magic here. Right, it's just my brain has become specialized at knowing this particular bit of information. It's not even that, you know, wow, big deal, okay? Do you know what I mean? Yeah, it's the same with language. If you're gonna learn another language, you have to be using it. You have to be, the only way to become fluent, yeah, is to use it. What's your brain doing? Your brain is building connections between the language parts, the different language parts within the brain are building connections with each other. So that you learn, your brain learns to actually, you know, learns the grammar, learns how to sort of speak in that language, and it's the same thing. So I'm gonna try to not set you so much kind of formative tasks, because I'm gonna try and start taking away these stabilizers off the wheels. You know, say you are learners, you're gonna go to university, hopefully. You know, these are the study habits and skills you need, and I'm trying to point you, I'm gonna signpost them to you, all right? But it's up to you to walk down that road. I can't force you, yeah? But I'm just gonna say, strong recommendation here is that you do, I would say Monday nights, you just take 15 minutes, review what we did last week, okay? Make sense? Okay, I'm not gonna ask you to share what's on here for now. You can keep it, you can throw it away, do what you wanna do with it, I don't mind, okay? In future, I may ask you to come back to it. One thing I've noticed, all right, but I just read a few of these. Some people are talking about proteins and energy, okay? What are the biological molecules responsible for giving us energy?
Carbohydrates.
And in terms of energy storage, what's the other ones?
Hydrogen.
So that's a type of carbohydrate. Huh?
Sugars.
So they're carbohydrates. Sugars are carbohydrates. So we burn sugars in respiration, mm-hmm. Yep, to release energy. What do we use to store energy? Some sugars we do, glycogen
ATP,
we do.
I know that's producing energy.
Lipids, yeah. Long-term energy stores, yeah? Yeah? What's happening when you put on weight is your body is or you put on fat, your body's trying to store energy for long term. Yeah, why do animals hibernate? They tend to eat lots of food, get themselves really fat, so they can sleep through the winter. Yeah. So lipids can be used as long-term energy stores. What are the functions then of proteins?
There are several, depending on what.
Good. There's lots of different types. It's not. They're not used necessarily for energy. They can be, but it's not their primary function. Your body will only burn proteins when it's run out of sugars to burn and when it's run out of fats to burn. Okay? And if it starts to burn protein, that's really bad, because it means what it's doing is your body's effectively digesting its own muscle.
Yeah.
Okay? And that's serious malnourishment. Okay? I used to do a lot of climbing. I haven't done any for a number of years, but there were a couple, have you ever seen the film Touching the Void? Okay, anyway, it's about these two climbers who went up this peak in the South America, and basically one of them fell, broke his leg. The other guy, it's a long story, but anyway, this guy who broke his leg ended up in a crevasse and managed to crawl himself back to camp and da-da-da-da-da. He survived when he should have been against all the odds. In 3 days, right, his body lost 40% of its weight. 3 days. Okay? Because he was so under so much physical exertion. What had it done is obviously eaten all the sugar, alright? Then it burned through all the fat, and then his muscles had actually started to actually waste. Your body will eat itself effectively to keep itself alive in extremis. We need to somehow untangle that in a few of your minds, because when we talk about proteins, we're not in terms of functions, we're not really thinking about energy. We're thinking about hormones. We're thinking about enzymes, which we're going to get onto next week. Tomorrow we should start enzymes. We're going to be thinking about structural proteins. Okay, they have a variety of functions, but energy is really not the main function of proteins. Okay, other things you should remember is they contain nitrogen. Other things that they have polymers called polypeptides and proteins, and the monomers, the single subunits are called amino acids. There are 20 amino acids. We did a few maths calculations last week where we tried to work out like how many proteins can you build from with 100 amino acids in chain, how many different, we said there was like 10 to the power 200 or something, was it, I think? I can't remember, something like that. Do you remember that from last week? Okay. Okay, let me just move this out. So, last week we started this exercise. If we can now go to our facts about proteins in our workbook. Okay, so I just want to review some of these exercises with you. So we said that the first question, what part of amino acid determines its properties and defines it? We said that's the R group. Okay, Leo, are you with us? Do you want to come back over here, sir? Feel free to come. You're kind of out on a limb there, sort of like a satellite student. Come back. Don't be a stranger. Okay, Lewis, do you think you could explain to me what an R group is, or what you understand as about an R group?
An R group is it's like a region.
Yep.
Structure of amino acids, and the structure of amino acids.
Yeah.
So like different proteins have different, no, different amino acids have different R groups.
Brilliant, sir. Well done. So different amino, it's the proper part that defines the amino acid. Different amino acids will have different R groups. Okay, good. Okay, and then I ask you to pick three. Now, I'm stressing you don't need to know the structure of individual amino acids, okay? You should be aware, you should be able to identify them because they contain nitrogen. Okay, that's what you're looking for. If you ever asked what type of molecule is this in an exam, and it's got a nitrogen, N in it, it is an amino acid. That's it, okay? You don't need to know the individual. There's 20 of them. You don't need. I did a degree in zoology, right? And I've never been required to learn the different amino acids. Okay, so don't worry about that. But I just wanted to illustrate the point about the R group. So, could you just tell me one of your amino acids, Lewis, and what the R group? What? Just describe the R group to us if you can.
Okay. Yeah. So we have
just one of them.
Okay, well, serine then.
Serine. Yeah. Yep.
It has. I'm not really sure how it's. So it has a carbon atom.
Yep.
Which has like three links to two hydrogen and one.
Okay. Cool. So it's got a hydroxyl group. So the R group is. We've got our NH2. So this is our amine group.
Yeah.
Okay, so the general structure of amino acid, we've got our amine group and our carboxylic acid group with a middle carbon, which is where we've got the R group, and you're saying that we've got a...
OH and...
We've got a C with a...
Yeah, sorry, C,
OH.
OH and two H's.
Yeah, so that's your R group for serine. Okay, cool. Leo, did you manage to do this? Did you manage to get an amino acid? Yeah, cool. Could you give me one of them?
I did the arginine. How do you say this one?
Can you spell it for me?
A-N-G-E.
Sorry. Mr. Arginine. A-R-G-I.
I, sorry. N-I-N-E.
Arginine. Okay, cool. So again, NH2. I'm just going to write NH2 instead of drawing the structure, okay? That's. Do you understand that that's the same as that? Yeah. NH2. Okay, C-C-O-O-H. So our group would go here. So what would it look like, sir?
Can
you just tell me what it's got in it? Oh, it's a complicated one. Look, so there's my NH2. There's my OOH. So you've got 1, 2, 3. Wow. Okay, what's that? NH, is it?
Yeah.
So it's three. So you've got three carbons like this. And then you've got an N.
Yeah,
what else have we got?
NH. I got an NH with a 3.
Oh my, yeah. That's a very complicated one. And then a C.
And after an NH.
So that's H. H. Well, that can't be right. It has to be just that. Okay, so all these carbons have got hydrogens on them as well. And then we've got, what's on top, attached to the carbon? Put them?
NH.
So we've got another NH.
NH2.
NH2.
No, NH and NH2.
Okay, so that'll be NH like that.
Yep.
Yeah, okay. So, basically, both amino acids, all right, but you can see that the R group can be kind of complicated, okay? You're not expected to know the individual ones, all right? Just wanted to illustrate the point. Okay, let's move on. Okay, so I said there are 20 different amino acids found within polypeptides synthesized on ribosomes. Okay, Raphael, eukaryotic cells have what size ribosomes?
Sorry.
Eukaryotic cells have what size ribosomes? Can you remember? Put you on the spot. India? So it's that number.
The ADS.
ATS, yes, that's a measure of the size. ATS.
Oh, size.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, sorry. Maybe I didn't make that clear. We're, when we get onto actually translation and looking at how proteins are made, we will look at that in a bit more detail. But yes, so 70S on prokaryotes are smaller than the 80S in eukaryotes. Okay. So each of these can be linked together in any combination. Therefore, any one of 20 amino acids can be found in any position within a polypeptide. Right. I think you struggled to find this information. I went and dug it out. I've got it here. I went and did it myself. Because I think it would be a bit, the database was a bit complicated for you guys to use. So you can add this in, but it's quite interesting. This is just to illustrate the point that different proteins can have different numbers of amino acids, and they can also have different numbers of polypeptide chains. Okay? So I found out that Rubisco, you might want to write these in, okay, is actually made of 16 polypeptides. Okay, so it has 16 polypeptides. All right? And it's quite complicated. It has 8 long chain polypeptides and 8 short chain polypeptides. Now, what does that mean, that long chain and that short chain? When I talk about a polypeptide being a chain, what do you think I mean, Rhea?
The combination of amino acids.
Good, okay.
C-A-T something.
So, yeah, so when we take our amino acids, we join them together, right? I'm just going to wait for the others to finish writing. So remember from last week, when we take 2 amino acids, we join them together via a condensation reaction. Remember that? Yes? And we form what's called a peptide bond between the 2 amino acids. If we take 10, 20, 30 amino acids, we can link them together into a chain. They become a chain of amino acids. Okay? So a polypeptide is just a chain of amino acids. Yeah? So when I talk about a long chain and short chain, it's just the length of the amino acids. So the number of amino acids for Rubisco, in the long chain, there are 477 amino acids joined together. And in the short chain, there is 123. So we have 16 polypeptide chains in one protein, eight of which we call long chain, eight of which we call short chain. The long chains have 477 amino acids, and the short chains have 123 amino acids. Okay? Again, you do not need to know this. This is just to illustrate the fact that different proteins have different sizes, effectively. Okay, so just a bit of fun information for you. Fun. Yay. Yeah? But please don't... I'd make a note, maybe write on there, you do not need to learn this. You will not have any test where it's asking you how many amino acids in Rubisco, how many amino acids in hemoglobin. It's not going to happen. Okay? So insulin, it's got 51 amino acids in it. And it has two polypeptide chains. So a bit more simple. Collagen has three polypeptide chains. Each chain has 1,400 amino acids in it.
Collagen has, sorry, three chains.
Three chains, yeah, three chains. 1,400 amino acids per chain, so it's big. If you compare it to insulin, which has got 51 amino acids, it's huge. Yeah? Think, imagine a tower that's got 51 Lego bricks, another one that's got 1,400. Think of that size difference. Okay, so basically the point is proteins are really diverse. Really diverse. Okay, hemoglobin. Okay, it's got four chains. Two alpha and two beta, what we call them. So each hemoglobin molecule has two alpha chains. Alpha is written like this. Alpha chains. And then beta is written like that. They're Greek letters. So hemoglobin has two alpha chains, has two beta chains. The alpha chain has 141 amino acids, and the beta chain has 146.
It's per chain, right?
Per chain, yeah. Amino acids per chain, yeah. I'm just going to skip down to rhodopsin, which is simple. It's two chains, two polypeptide chains, and it's made of 348 amino acids in total, I believe.
Why is there a long and a short one, and then there's an alpha and a beta?
It's just the scientists who study it, when they publish in their journals, that's just, if they've discovered, you know, when they've worked out the structure, they may have just called it a long chain or a short chain. It's just quirks of knowledge discovery, I think, okay? There isn't a rule book that says you must name this da-da-da-da, okay? So when we talk about hemoglobin, we just call it the alpha and beta. And I guess, I mean, their sizes... there's a difference of five amino acids, so they're basically the same sort of size. Whereas when you talk about the long and the short there, in Rubisco, there's a huge difference in size. It's four times the size. Okay, so spider silk was really struggling to find, but I had to, actually this is a reference to a actual article. But basically, it's a repeating polymer, but it has two chains which have eight amino acids in them each. So these chains are quite small, but they're repeated over and over and over again. So, spider silk, two chains which have eight amino acids each. Okay? All right. We're going to skip exercise three. It's totally optional. I put it in there for a cover work if I was away, but we're not going to. right, there is some really good information here on these pages. I would suggest you go and have a read of them. There's basically detailed information on each of the proteins here. So we've got collagen, structure and movement, what it's used for in collagen. Transport, so hemoglobin used in transport. Defense and survival, so immunoglobulins as proteins, what they actually do. We'll probably, for the higher level, when we get onto the higher level part, we'll look at this in a little bit more detail, so don't worry about it too much. Okay, what I'd like you to do now is to go on to protein shape and structure. I'm going to ask you to, with the last, how long have we got left? Yeah, 12 minutes. Okay, so I'd like you to just to go through to the textbook now. Have a read of the section on protein shape and structure. I'll get this for you. And I'd like you to now practice summarizing your own notes for this. Okay? So, in your own words, summarize how the amino acid sequence determines the three-dimensional structure of proteins. Let me just, I'll tell you what page you need. So this would be page 91 and 92, including the orange box. 91 and 92, including the orange box on page 92. So page 91, from protein conformations. Okay? They're from protein conformations. So just right at the bottom of page 91. So that, and then 92, including the orange box. In your own words, summarize how the amino acid sequence determines the three-dimensional structure of protein, and then how heat and pH affect proteins.